Hello friends, I am Ashutosh Sahu. Welcome to the third session of Financing the Value Chain Management. In this session, we will be discussing about financial instrument for rural sector. So before starting about different financial instruments, let us discuss about what are the factors on which the financial instruments offered depends on and who are the actors involved. First, the financial instrument offered by the financier in a particular region depends on the following factors. Those factors are the level of sophistication of the financial system in that particular area. Second is the risk bearing ability of the financier, and the third one is the regulatory norms and awareness level amongst the farmers and the artisans in that region. And secondly, we will discuss about who are the actors involved in need of financiers approach. The actors involved are local financial institutions, commercial banks, development banks, government, and different actors involved in the value chain. Now we will be discussing about direct finance. Under this, there are some common financial instruments. Those are savings, inclusive finance or microfinance, traditional finance, leasing and factoring, weather-based insurance, credit guarantee schemes, Kisan credit card. We will be discussing all of these one by one. So in the traditional approach, individual actors in a business are provided with the finance. These actors could be the input suppliers, processors, farmers, traders or distributors. All of them need finances to grow their businesses, and the most common financial instruments are savings. Individual or community savings is a very common source of financing in most part of the world. In India also, this is a common practice. Extended or joint families also have a system of supporting members through savings. We generally consider this as an informal financial sector. Then we will be discussing about inclusive finance, which is commonly known as microfinance. Most of us have heard the term microfinance, which is again a very similar to informal financial sector, with the only difference being in the sense of responsibility that the lender and lendee takes. Microfinance is popular in rural areas of our country, and self-help groups, SHGs, play a crucial role in identifying the actors, disbursing the finance and ensuring the repayment. Then we will be discussing about traditional finance. Traditional finance instruments from organizations like commercial banks, agricultural development banks, NGOs, cooperatives, etc. can be in the form of loans, lease or equity finance. Often the finances can come from government agency and international bodies like World Bank, etc. Then leasing and factoring. Leasing and factoring are more complex and innovative financial instruments meant for the farmers and other entrepreneurs. Leasing is generally used for purchasing farm equipments, automobile, machineries that are used in the agriculture. And the factoring is when the actor sells its invoice at a discount to improve the cash flow. These instruments are used for borrowers who have limited availability of collateral but have a sound credit history. Then we will be discussing about weather-based insurance. In our country, agriculture is majorly dependent on weather. Some financial institutions find it easier to provide finance based on insurance against bad weather. The assessment becomes quite easier as compared to insurance against production losses. This type of financial instrument might not be useful in the region where the objective data on the climate or the weather is not available. Then we'll be discussing about the credit guarantee schemes. These instruments improve the chances of access to finance. And under this scheme, the financial institutions takes partial guarantee of the losses due to default. Then Kisan Credit Card, KCC. The Kisan Credit Card scheme aims to provide an adequate and timely institutional credit to farmers with a very simplified and flexible procedures. The scheme is implemented by scheduled commercial banks, regional rural banks and cooperatives bank. It comprises both short-term crop and the term loan components also. We will be discussing what is the meaning of short-term crop loan and what is the meaning of term loan in the further slides. This table provides us also information about the targets and the achievements for agricultural credit. And the source is the NABARD, which is the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. As you can see, in 2016-17 and 17-18, the overall target of commercial banks, cooperative banks and regional rural banks was 9,000 and 10,000 respectively, and the achievement is 10,658 and 11,685 respectively, which means the target has been achieved each year. Then this table provides also information about Kisan Credit Card scheme for the year 2016-17 and 17-18, and the source is public sector banks and the private sector banks. As you can see, the number of operative cases has been increased from 23.37 million to 23.53 million in a year, and the outstanding crop loan and outstanding term loan only the outstanding crop loan has been increased and the outstanding term loan has been decreased. What is the meaning of outstanding crop loan? Outstanding crop loan is a short-term advance that is given to the farmers by the banks or the cooperative societies to finance the purchase of improved quality seeds, fertilizers or machineries. And the outstanding term loans are the medium or the long-term loans. Then these are the financial instruments used in agricultural value chain finance. For example, in product financing, we use different financial instruments like trader credit, input supplier finance, marketing and wholesale company finance, leading firm financing. In receivable financing, different instruments used are trade receivable finance, factoring, forfeiting. In physical asset collateralization, we use different types of financial instruments such as warehouse receipts finance, repurchase agreements, financial leasing. In risk mitigation products, we use different types of financial instruments like insurance, forward contracts and futures. In financial enhancement, different financial instruments used are loan guarantee, joint venture finance. So in the next session, we'll be discussing about the design and implementation of agricultural value chain finance. Till then, bye bye, take care. Thank you.